Hi there, this is Paula from Replicon. Today I'm going to show you how to set up time off in Replicon. This video is aimed at administrators, but it will also be useful to anyone who wants to better understand the time off features that we offer. The first thing to know about time off in Replicon is that it is highly customizable. I'm going to show you the features that are available by default, but keep in mind that we can easily create affordable custom options if the defaults don't meet your requirements. In this video, I'll be covering the four basic steps of setting up time off: setting up time off types, configuring accrual policies, setting up time off templates, and assigning time off settings to users. So I won't be covering more advanced setup like holiday auto-population in this video. A time off type is exactly what it sounds like. It represents a kind of time off, like sick time, vacation time, personal leave, etc. You'll need to define a time off type for each kind of time off employees can take in your organization. For each type, you can define some settings. Settings include the display units, either hours or days, how the balance displays in time off bookings, whether or not users can edit or delete bookings, the minimum increment users can book off, and booking validations, which can also be set at the user level, as I'll show you later. These settings can differ from one time off type to the next. For example, you could use hours to track vacation time off, but days to track sick leave. But for each time off type, these settings are global, meaning that they apply to all users assigned the type. So every user assigned your vacation time off type would see their vacation time in hours. Accrual policies define how much time off a user can take. Each policy is a set of rules that decide things like when time off will be added to the user's balance and when their balance will reset, and define any other limits on how much time off a user can take. Note that you don't have to assign time off policies. If you only want to track the amount of time off that was taken, and you don't need to set any limits on the balance available, you can assign a user a time off type with no policy set up. But assuming you do want to limit how much time off they can take, you'll probably want to set up a default policy for each time off type. This is the policy that will automatically appear when you assign a time off type to a user, so we recommend that default policies reflect your most common settings to minimize the amount of customization you'll need to do when you're setting up users. As you can see, there are four types of rules you can set up in accrual policies. A starting policy rule does what it sounds like. It defines how much time off a user has at the start of a policy and includes a setting that allows you to carry over time off if the policy is replacing one that's already in effect. An accrual rule defines the schedule on which time off will be added to the balance for this time off type. For example, you could specify that a day of vacation is added on the first of every month. To make this easier to set, you simply enter the annual time off allotment, say 3 weeks vacation, and choose the schedule, and Replicon will divide it accordingly. Note a default rule allows users to accrue time based on the number of hours they worked, which is useful in states that require employers to grant users an hour of sick time for every 30 hours worked. Limitation rules include the ability to define resets. For example, you could set a user's sick balance to reset to 5 days on the 1st of January every year. Limitation rules also include maximum balance limits, allowing you to, for example, block a user's balance from ever exceeding 20 days. Note that we offer a default expiry rule that lets you set hours carried over from last year to expire, say after 90 days. And finally, you can apply validation rules to the policy. These prevent users from submitting bookings that don't meet defined requirements. For example, you can prevent them from overdrawing their available balance by more than, say, 2 days. A couple of final notes about policies. First, when you're setting up a time off type, note that you aren't limited to creating a single default policy. You can define a set of policies based on users' anniversary dates. This is useful if your organization has set rules around increases in time off allotment. Say, each user starts with 2 weeks of vacation and is bumped up to 3 weeks after 2 years of service. Assigning a set of policies means you don't have to remember to make policy changes later. They'll be applied automatically on the schedule you select. And finally, note that policies can be offset, so they come into effect only after a probationary period, say 3 months of employment, for example. There's one more small thing to configure before we start assigning settings to users: time off templates. Each time off user must be assigned a single time off template, which grants them permission to use time off functionality in Replicon. Time off templates also specify a couple of other things, like whether the user sees other users' time off in their time off calendar. So you want to check that they're configured appropriately for your purposes before assigning them to users. Now that I've configured time off types with their default accrual policies and time off templates, I can assign those things to users. So let's go to the user profile of a new user and select the time off page. Next, I'll select the time off template I just set up, so this user will have permission to access time off features. I'll also assign a time off approval path. Search approvals at replicon.com/help if you need more information on setting up approvals. Then, I'll add all time off types this user should have access to. Note that if I've set up a default accrual policy for a time off type, it will display when I add that type. If I want to use the default settings, I'll simply click Save at this point. But if I want to customize the policy settings for the user, I need to do that now. For example, this default policy gives the user 3 weeks, or 120 hours, of annual vacation. But let's say this user is very senior and gets 5 weeks of vacation. I can update their vacation policy to reflect this amount. Finally, I'll save the updated policy. Be sure to click Save even if you're just assigning the defaults to ensure these settings are saved. And that's about it for setting up time off. If you have questions or need more information, please go to our help system at www.replicon.com/help. Or post a question in our community, or contact Replicon support. That's all from me for now. Thanks for your time.